Welcome back to Hand of Fate. Let's get started on the next round. I think it's the King of Dust.
You can now access Endless Mode.
Don't care.
If you wish to test your skills against chance.
The King of Dust, our first, true big villain. Compensation. Whenever a player finishes a combat, you will lose 1 gold per 15 health. That you have?
Some men thrive in anarchy and chaos. The King of Dust is one such. His tools are cruelty and terror, and I suspect he will harbor a great hatred for you, my friend.
Killed his family.
In these lands, the King of Dust takes
lots of ambushes. Ooh, 6 of dust now in the deck. Some shops.
You face the first of my kings. Each has shaped the nature of their forces with the strength of their will. They will turn that power to your destruction.
They may. This is probably a slightly harder level. The hero of Embertown.
A quest that may lead you down many paths.
Come across an injured adventurer.
Jealously guarded secrets.
Whose battered and bloodied armor tells you he's seen combat recently. Let's ask his troubles. I've been chasing a pack of thieves that attacked my home village of Embertown. I killed some of them in an ambush, but I fear I lack the strength to chase the rest down. If you have any honor, you will find these jackals and make them pay. Ooh, Embertown Hero. It's like part 2 of it. Okay, so you don't have to. But you should. The Helpful Priest. Just always say yes, give him your damn food. And if I'm lucky, I can get
a choice.
Huge success. Follow that card, man. 2 blessings. Retribution. Player struck by a range. There's a chance the attacker will be stunned. That's nice. Critical. Triple damage.
Many of these blessings are too good for the likes of you.
I gotta remember that. Ooh, the Embertown Hero already.
Let's find out what type of character you really are.
You've caught up with the Embertown Village Raiders, who call out, "Stay your hand, adventurer, and we will share the spoils with you." Refuse to deal with the thieving scum. You tell them to ask their gods for mercy. Mercy, then you are about to show... That you're about to show them? The dealer draws you 1 monster card. 2 of dust. This is going to be pretty easy unless there's some difficult terrain. Oh, I have a special. What is it? The critical strike a stun. Okay. Tavern Brawl. Critical strike, I don't seem to be working that great. Or I need to cue them. Yeah, there's not a clear indication. I might be getting critical strikes, but I don't really know. I lost gold, I guess? 3 gain cards. Max, that works for me. Gold.
I'm sure you're great.
And gold. Silence, he hands you a jeweled ring, then dies. You put the ring away to identify later and bury the fallen champion. The card's token is now yours. Thank you. And the stairs or wagon rack.
Descend ever deeper into the subterranean pit. Do you understand how this game works now? Do you comprehend the stakes?
Not really. Dead King's Hall
crypt
again?
Rubbing. I'm not sure the dead fighting back makes this any more dignified.
That's a pretty easy one. Let's try to take him by surprise. This could be really awesome. I don't know, maybe that one. Yes! Do I get an auto win? Suddenly you leap into the fray, taking one of them down before they can even react. Okay, so it's... Oh, I took 2 of them down. 1 card goes down. That's quite strong. and I think there might be traps. I see spike floor in front of me. I can at least avoid that, but if I roll into it... Alright, be careful. Yeah, you come to me. Oh, dodge! Oh, I ran right into that. Double kill with a trap? Fuck yeah. Three game cards. Equipment. Let's see, during combat, strikes sustained from bows. Chance to restore your cooldowns. Sure, whatever. Seems fine to me. Food always good. Should last me a while. Call for the priest. In a shady road off the beaten trail, you find a traveling merchant looking to trade with wandering adventurers. I have just enough money, I might be able to get something. Or I could just stock up on food. Like, the good stuff's like at least 50 or 60. Oh, it's too expensive. I could buy a blessing, maybe? Too expensive. I could sell. I don't have any low-level stuff to sell. How much does a heal cost? $8? Sure. Everything helps. Should be good on food for now, I think, because I'll get the gain cards.
Bandits are sorely loyal to their king. They will not let you reach him easily.
Yeah, I don't know how the criticals work. The right click's supposed to stun, but there's no critical indicator. Watch out for the knife throwing. Nice. Finish him. Oh, I cued him. Oh, he doesn't have a beard. He does. I thought it was chops for a second. Beards are really popular in this fantasy setting. Yeah. You're dead, dude. Fucking dead. Kill the survivor. Three gains. Triple. Oh, nice. What do they do? I'll take the ring of survival. I don't know what this does. Oh, third combat. 20 health. 3 food. And some gold. More ratmen.
It seems you have made an enemy of the ratmen. They do not normally attack unless provoked. Our old friend, the Jack of
Blades,
returns to fight another day.
This is the first time this has happened, where an actual face card comes back. This is nasty. Oh, and he's got friends. Ay, ay, ay. And I've got no specials. I just gotta do this straight up. Oh, I jumped! Watch out! Oh, damn! Thank you! Oy-yi-yi-yi! Oh, damn. Damn. All right, let's finish this dude. Oh. Let's get get him in the corner, and the rat jack goes down. Scary stuff, though. Ah, food. That works. Let's get that wagon rad. Oh, cave mouth. This is new. Nothing to say? The next stop on your journey takes you from a cave out to the feet of an imposing forest. Let's exit the cave. I didn't even know I was in a cave. You embark upon the next leg of your adventure.
What brings you to play the game? Ha. I know you will not tell me. Like all the rest, you are silent.
Gained almost full health. Devil's Carnival.
At its heart, these traveling shows are but mockeries of the true mysteries.
Once, one day, just as dusk gathers, you reach a large country town hosting a traveling circus. Strange sights and stranger smells confront you as you begin to wander between tents and stalls that were once brightly colored, but now are faded and stained with dust. Peasants and nobles alike wander the streets and alleys, past wonders and amazement, seeming almost dazed. There's something about this place that dulls your senses, and for a while you forget your quest, forget even the path that brought you to this place. Oh, this is not good. Fuck. Alright, what happens? A black cat darts out and waves between your legs. Distracted, you take a wrong turn and wander down a darkened alley. Mysteries of the carnival await you. Oh, shit. I'm not totally fucked necessarily. There's a success. Genuine unicorn tonic can cure any injury, whether from sword or claw. A man calls, holding up a bottle. He suddenly slashes your arm with a knife, and as you open your mouth to protest, he flicks the bottle, splashing some tonic on you. You start to reach for your weapon, but then stop. The crowd leans in and watches the wound in your arm closes before your very eyes. Made from genuine unicorns and 7 secret ingredients. Available here for only one night. The dealer draws 1 health gain card. Okay. The crowd surges forward to buy this miracle potion, and you walk on, smelling of ground-up unicorn horn, elvish blood, ratman sweat, and several other pungent odors you can't identify. Sometime later, you find yourself standing at the edge of a forest, like sounds of the crowds behind you. Day is just dawning. But which day? Looking back, you can see the ruined buildings of a country town, long ago abandoned. No success there. But I did gain a little health. Culling the Ratmen.
Our lives
an ally, perhaps.
Thus, are they not? Pushed back and forth by the whims of nobility or power.
Alright.
We play for a token now.
All the lands in the kingdom are being overrun with ratmen. Merchants in my lands are attacked on the road, as are any travelers such as yourself. My guards are needed here, with me, but if I had just 50 gold, I would hire a mercenary to find their nests and cull their numbers. Pay the Duke 50 gold? Wait, my guards. But if I had 50 gold, I would hire a mercenary army to find their nests. I don't have 50 gold. I understand that contributing to the common good may be unfamiliar to your sort, but I urge you to return immediately if you change your mind, or get some money. Another ambush.
You may have to contend with every bandit in the kingdom before you reach the king.
Alright, 3 of dust. Full health, though. Decent amount of food, so hopefully I can get some gold and equipment. I got no special equipment or anything. Oh, dodge. Out of range, boy. Nice. Dodge. And roundhouse kick. I'd so love to learn how to use a roundhouse kick with a sword stroke. It's like, it's fucking Jedi shit. All right. Sneak up and kill the last one. Or the one who's pretending to be dead. But just don't draw that one. So just pick the top card. And three gain cards. Armory.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Ooh. I want the Berserker armor. Every hit you sustain
armor
increases your speed
you
and weapon
proportional strength and power of a barbarian, which you are on closer examination.
That is true. And there's my 50 gold. Let's do this.
He is not your duke, remember. He can only ask, not order.
Self, let's pay the gold. A wise decision. I shall begin a campaign against these filthy rats immediately. Also, you may take this blade. With my mercenary army, I won't need to rely on it to protect me. Awesome sword or rat cleaver?
Rats have so few
double damage.
Mankind.
Plus one to cause
yet
a force explosion.
Yet the two have lived in close proximity throughout the ages and are more similar than either would care to admit.
That was pure ownage just now. Traveling, I've got nothing. Guess I could sell something real quick. What is the red band? What does it mean? It's not like token worthy. Is it like, is it DLC maybe? Anyways, not one time I wait. Yeah, sell my standard axe. It's worthless now. Sell the Chains of Rage. Alright, great. We're pretty good for food. So, oh, what stuff to buy? I can only get this. Lizardmen take double damage from player. I'm not fighting lizardmen. Or am I? I'm fighting ratmen, not lizardmen. So that's not a concern of mine. Gotta continue with our quest!
Bound once more, seeking the heart of it all. Did you expect me to tell your fortune? No. A fortune teller is at their most base and despicable when they begin to believe their own lies. Of course, I am different. My powers are genuine.
Of course they are. Let's play the game. More ratmen, but I got double damage.
Killing their leader is a fine way to provoke them.
One monster card. Six. Oh shit. But I got double damage, so this might end quickly. Give me that rat cleaver. I don't have any specials. Oh damn. I want these archers gone! Oh well. Just power through. Nice. I think I was getting some poison damage in there. I'm showing negative two, but maybe that's a bug. Oh, plus 20, nice. You find nothing of value. It fucking sucks. Let's do a free heal. Very nice. And full health. Cave mouth. Is this to leave? The next step in your journey takes you from a cave to the feet of an imposing forest. No way. We need to clear the cave. Get this shop I have not been to. Shitty Grove, off the beaten trail, you find a traveling merchant. I haven't found just shop. I have no new stuff, so I guess I'll just, I don't have much gold either. But exploring this cave, I could use a few more food. Let's see what he's got. Expensive helms. Oh, armor of cold. Your enemies are immediately slowed. That's cool. costs. Buy a little something something. That's one food. Yeah, I'm just ditching gold for this adventure. Just... Alright. Because food equals health, too. Let's explore this cave. Ooh, Elysian Underworld.
Again, a token is at stake.
As you attempt to discover more about the bizarre portal you encountered, one name keeps recurring, a mystic named Alicia. Apparently her expertise on all aspects of shadow realms, interdimensional travel, and beasts of the void is unparalleled. That's the smallest text I've seen so far. You track Alicia's caravan. She travels under the guise of a fortune teller. Her appearance doesn't match the whispers about her. She's considerably shorter and much more of a beard. She audibly clears her throat before speaking to you. Welcome, stranger. She recoils in mock blindness. The dark clouds of fate swirl around you in a tempest. For little gold, fuck, I can help you see your fortune through the storm. Explain your interest in finding more about the underworld. The mystic looks around nervously before saying, Now, what makes you think that I'd know anything about such things? I am but a humble fortune teller. Can I not interest you in such services? 3 gold to be told your fortune. I don't have it. You decide not to pay for tricks and half-truths and leave the mystic's caravan. Not getting my token. Fuck. But I can come back. I can come back. Let's fight these rat men. Maybe get some stuff. Archers first this time. Let's charge right through him. Oh, I'll dodge. I'll go. Oh, yeah. Done, archer. Oh, you got me. Kick you in the face! Shield bass. He has cool moves. And just button mashing, too. Okay. That'll do me. Alright, this
Though
fight...
I admire his ilk, I live by a very different...
Makes no difference, so I'm fighting 12 dust. You are no mighty hero,
Six
I will die by your choice.
To keep you on your toes.
Okay, that's fair. Should have been like a 5 bandit choice, just so you could... have different options. Alright, just watch out for the throwing knives. There you go. Yeah. It's... Oh! Dutch. Bam. Oh, that's a nice finisher of that shield bash. It's a punch. The rat thing was lighting up. I wonder if there's a special it has. Alright, I might get... If I get 3 gold, I can do it. Armor of Cold. Sweet.
Bullshit, adventurer. This armor pulls energy from the world around you.
Yes. That's what I needed. And more than enough.
I'm sure you're grateful for that.
Plenty of food. Let's go back to this.
If you plunder the secrets of your memories, you'll gain new cards.
First I'll explain
Some
my interest.
You wish you'd left untouched.
And then I'll pay my 3 gold. Ah, oh, shit. It's gonna be tough.
Choose from these options.
Yes! The mystic's eyes flash wide open. You, your fortune is awash with death and destruction. But there is also hope. You carry the favors with you. How may I aid you in your endeavors? To someone with such a powerful aura as yours, I could tell of what I know. The price for such information, though, would be high. Sadly, I see that you have nothing I desire, no powerful magical artifacts. Perhaps if you returned with one, I would be more forthcoming. Damn! You cannot even, like, no. Don't need it. Pass by. Let's get the hell out of here.
At their heart, all games are about power, are they not? The acquiring of power. The retaining of power, and most importantly, the use of power.
Very interesting. Be all again, ambush all day.
A surprise attack. The novelty must wear
the jack
on
of dust.
Travels.
It's rough. I thought he was supposed to be dead. No, he can't revive. All right, let's. Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Uh-oh. There you go. Oh, he's stunned. Waste of that. Not today, buddy. Ugh. Stun attack. Take out his legs. Straight through him. All right. I did good in that combat. Let's see. Alright. Same old, same old. It's the top card. Just don't pick the top card. We're good. Equipment. Scorching Zeal.
Fire. In its multitudinous
trait burns
forms,
the flame of the ancients.
Still
extra fire damage. Lava golems will shrug off the fire attacks with ease. That's pretty awesome. I've got a rat cleaver, which... Am I going after the rat king at this point? I'm going after the dust king, right? I'll try
really?
It out.
Is that what you're going to do?
Some gold. Sweet. Unless I totally forgot what's going on. Mr. Lionel. How are you doing, Lionel? Let's ask him what he wants. Give me some free shit. Let's see. Angel wings. Greater
Move
movement speed.
Move quickly from here. There is little material gain to be made.
Battle at Brooktop.
These places are rife with power. It is not chance that you should meet a warlock here. Let us stake a token on their foolishness.
A light draws you to a nearby hilltop where you see a warlock disappear in a cloud of sulfur, leaving behind his summoned minions. So you just gotta fight him. Oh, that's bad.
No king falls without a challenge.
That's rough, but I'm full health. Full health. It's gonna be rough, though. Jack of Skulls with dust minions to help him out, like... Ugh. And he's gonna have skeletal minions too. Yep. But I got this fire thing. So hopefully that will help me somehow. What the hell? Oh, yeah, yeah. Bam. Oh, rough. Damn. You guys are done. Finish him. Get your minions out of here. Damn, that was tough. And he has a feather in his hat too. That was helping him. Yeah, that fire attack, I guess it was a stun or something. After the battle, you search the bodies for loot to gain cards. Food. And food. More than enough food. As you climb down the other side of the hill, you spy what looks like the remains of an ancient temple on another nearby hilltop. The card's token is now yours.
Here is your token. Well done.
Why, thank you. Oh, the White Council. This is a combat.
I will happily wager on the outcome. I do not think you have what it takes.
I don't either. One day, as you travel through a forest, you come across a band of thugs standing on the roadside. As you draw near, they move to block your path. The other draws two monster cards. A 6 and a 4. Half your gold, refuse, go back the way you came. I think I have to fight these dudes. The White Council doesn't like armed mercenaries wandering through their land, the man says, and his goons close in around you. They're dusters. Oh, I have a helm that does something. Snapper. Alright. That's some damage, though. As you approach one of the fallen men, he says with some effort, "You'll regret this. There will be consequences." He cuts off his voice. He cuts off as his voice fails him. You notice a robed figure standing in the shadows of the forest. He waves his hand and a magical portal appears. Stepping through it, he is quickly gone. You look around to find no trace of the fight remains. This card's token is now yours. So they were like spectral bandits. I got the food, so I'm just gonna do some of this action. Sneaky. I'll do the full heal. Nice. Oh, a shop. I totally don't have any gold. So that's not worth it. Me? Back to this.
This token will unlock more cards if you can defeat this encounter.
How much gold do I think I need? Like 20 gold. I think I'm gonna be short. Let's see. Let's try for it at least. Fuck. So he takes some gold from me, I guess? All yours for only 15 gold. Fine. Bard bestows upon you all the knowledge that he has gleaned about the White Minotaur. The card's token is yours. Okay, so I just had to pay more for it. Instead of like 3 or whatever it is. So this is probably the last encounter unless we have an extra area. Holy damn, this is long.
Head downwards, if you dare.
Like, This is so getting split up into episodes now.
On this floor, the King of Dust waits for you. He is prepared. Are you?
Nope. I want to get more food.
The wandering mendicant. Will humanity ever move beyond poverty, religion, and charity?
I'm kind of a priest wandering on the road. Do I have to give him half my food? See, he begs food to feed the orphans. The gods show favor to those who... How much food? Just one food? Worthy decision. How many young ones will see another summer? I'll risk it for 5 food. Ouch. I better get some good shit. Oh, I have failure potential here? Ugh. Good thing I didn't fail. That would have been bad. Gain card, and I get the token. Oh, I get a blessing. That's good. At the start of each combat, a random opponent is highlighted. If they're the first to die, it gives you gold. Okay.
The token is yours. Let us see what you do with your newfound abilities.
Those tokens are tempting.
The tale begins, and then proceeds relentlessly.
Okay.
With each step, you will discover a new card and a deeper mystery.
Couple of bandits. I think they're going down. Especially if I use my fire axe. Just make sure I need to dodge any knives. Nice! Oh, I cued him. What a bitch. Of course. There you go. 3 game cards. Armory. Ooh, Frost Fang or a Healer Ring. I got a pretty awesome weapon. But the Frost Fang's, it's so much faster. I'll take this. Even though it technically does less damage. I'm about to fight a... It won't matter. Fire... That won't matter. That just saved the day. That probably makes no difference. Ooh, treasure chest.
Open the chest, see what it contains. I'm curious.
This is hard. Fuck. Gas trap. Damn, this could go badly.
A choice. Select your
standard
desire.
Failure. 1 pain card. 5 health. That's nothing.
Oh dear.
Still get the chest though. Fuck. So bad. Fucking failure. This is probably the boss here. I'm full health, so I'm good. King of Dust. Fierce and bashful.
Very few are so foolish as to deliver themselves to the king.
King is fierce in battle, but loyal to his troops. He can choose to heal them during combat, but not resurrect. The King of Dust broke faith with king and country long ago, and has made himself rich and powerful through the judicious application of cruelty and terror, outside of law, for decades.
There's a token in it for you, if you win.
The king is fierce in battle, but okay, it's the same thing. Let's take him out. I have 4 minions. If he heals, I gotta... He's probably got like a crazy multi-attack, too. I got my ice sword. Oh, I can freeze him and fight everyone else. It's perfect. Oh, hunt, thanks. Oh, it's still it. Oh, he's got a boulder attack. Oh, damn.
Oy.
Thank you very much. Oh shit. Stun. Pretty weak by yourself. Dodge. He has no counterable stuff. Oh, I had to aim it. Fuck. Interrupted. Oh, I lost gold for some reason.
There are many who will be pleased that you have defeated the likes of my lesser king. As for me, I think you have but proven that I must defeat you entirely.
Okay.
A set of new trinkets for you.
Bandits,
you will
I
need
get
them.
Ring of Justice.
More.
Ratman, I get the rat cleaver. Sweet. Maybe just shows up in shops, I guess now. Brooktop Hill, I get the altar and 25 gold. This is the White Council, right? The White Council thugs. I get White Council Part 3. It's a really cool way to go about like a ongoing quest. For healing the Song of the White Mantar, I get hunting the huntsman. Donating food to the orphans, I get more food gain, Ring of Poverty, and Charity 2. Still three hidden cards there. Reward for defeating the Bandit King, we get Feathered Ice, Life's Limb, Jack of Scales, Heroes Remains, Strangers in Shadows, and Old Graveyard. Very nice.
Come once more to the game.
And I shall, in the next episodes. Catch y'all then.